Hi guys, today's case is going to be on the bizarre behavior and disappearance of Daniel Robinson. Links to all my sources and extended articles will be in the description below. Please read the disclaimer and let's get into today's case. Daniel Cornelius Robinson was born into a loving family on January 14, 1997. He was one of five siblings, Daniel being the middle child. He had a good relationship with his siblings. They were all very close and protective over Daniel, but careful not to baby him too much. As you see, Daniel was born with a disability. He was born without his lower right arm, and his siblings were careful not to baby him, as they didn't want him to see himself any different from others. His siblings were very loving and encouraging and helped him to accept his disability. Daniel did not let his disability slow him down. He was a very confident and outspoken young man with a passion for adventure. Friends and family describe him as intelligent and a happy guy who loves spending time with his friends and family. Daniel graduated from the College of Charleston in South Carolina in 2019. It didn't take long for him to land a job as a field geologist with a company called Matrix New World Engineering in Phoenix, Arizona, where he later relocated. He was in charge of overseeing the remote desert sites. This was a dream job for Daniel. He loved being outdoors and hiking and examining various rock formations. Daniel also ran deliveries for Instacart to earn some extra cash on the side. In the weeks before his disappearance, while on one of these deliveries, he met a young woman named Caitlin. Allegedly, he made a delivery to Caitlin's home, and she and her friend invited him inside. According to her, he seemed friendly and the two exchanged phone numbers. But in the days to follow, he began behaving bizarrely, showing up to Caitlin's home multiple times unannounced. According to Caitlin, this made her extremely uncomfortable. Caitlin describes her interaction with Daniel to police in the days leading up to his disappearance. According to Caitlin, on that day, her and her female friend were at Caitlin's home, and they ordered food through a service called Instacart. Caitlin explained Instacart was a food ordering service similar to Grubhub and Uber. Caitlin said Daniel was the person who delivered their food that night. Caitlin said Daniel was very nice and she and her female friend asked Daniel if he wanted to hang out with them at that time. Caitlin said she and her female friend were drunk and that looking back on it, she shouldn't have invited a stranger into her home. Caitlin said she believed Daniel was harmless though, as he only had one arm and was short in height. Communication between the two are as follows. On Sunday, June 13th at 2:29 a.m., Caitlin texts Daniel a link to a podcast that they had been discussing. Not even a moment later, Daniel responds with, "Hey." The next day, Monday, June 14th at around 7:19 p.m., Daniel texts Caitlin again saying, "Hey, I accidentally left my canopy outside your house. Is it still there? If so, is it okay if I pick it up? Also, the podcast was great." Tuesday, June 15th at 1:37 p.m., Caitlin responds with, "Yes, you can pick it up whenever." A couple hours later at 8:30 p.m., Daniel texts, "Thanks, how do I get there again? Can I come now or tomorrow afternoon to grab it?" Wednesday, June 16th at 2:06 p.m., Caitlin responds with, "Hi, I saw you on the camera. I'm in Flagstaff and will be home later tonight. If you want, I can put it out front by the chairs before I head out for work tomorrow morning." An hour later, at 3:12 p.m., Daniel sends Caitlin a red heart emoji. The next day, Thursday, June 17th, at 6:39 p.m., Caitlin sends this text message, "Please stop showing up unannounced." Daniel responds with, "Okay, I won't ever again." Caitlin says, "Thanks, I'm looking right now and I don't see the canopy in the garage." Daniel says, "Don't worry about it, I already have it." Caitlin responds with a question mark. "I'm confused," she says. Daniel replies with, "I did grab it yesterday. I just wanted to tell you I'm sorry for disappearing the other day." At the end of the sentence in this message, he sends a sad face emoji. "I couldn't stop thinking about you." 2 days later, on Saturday, around 12:44 p.m., Daniel says, "Can we hang out?" Caitlin responds about an hour later with, "I'm not home." Daniel says, "Okay." On Sunday at 12:14 a.m., Daniel sends Caitlin, "I love you." Several hours later, at 8:28 a.m., Daniel asks, "Are you home today?" Caitlin responds about an hour later with, "Honestly, you showing up at my house unannounced made me extremely uncomfortable. I will not be home today, but I don't see us hanging out anytime soon." Daniel says, "Okay, but do you have any doubt? Either way, I will have to be okay with your answer." On Monday at around 11:44 a.m., Daniel texts Caitlin again. "How are you feeling?" he asks. This is when things get really creepy. At about 3:46 p.m., a couple of hours later, Daniel sends Caitlin, "I'm outside of your place." Caitlin responds with, ? "Please stop doing that. I am not even home. This is not okay." Daniel says, "I guess it's not." Caitlin goes on to say, "Not you guess. I've told you it is not okay to come to my home unannounced." Daniel asks, "Are you okay with me?" Caitlin responds, "No, this isn't normal nor acceptable." "What is normal?" Daniel says. Caitlin responds with, "Making plans before showing up to someone's home. And if someone has expressed to you that you've made them uncomfortable, you need to back off." Daniel says, "Do you hate me?" Her last text message to Daniel was, "I don't hate you, but please leave me alone." On Monday at 8:46 p.m., Daniel texts, "You're right." On Tuesday at 3:07 p.m., Daniel texts Caitlin one last time. He says, "The world can get better, but I'll have to take all the time I can, or we can, whatever to name it. I'll either see you again or never see you again." Daniel's family was aware of Caitlin, although they had never met her. His father recalls Daniel telling him that he was in love with a woman he had just met and didn't know anything about her. His father thought it was strange that Daniel was telling him this, that he would be in love with a person he didn't even know. Co-workers were also aware of the young woman, stating that Daniel had mentioned something about a girl he was in love with but couldn't have. Daniel's sister, Devisha, told police that Daniel had been talking about a woman recently that he was in love with. She said Daniel told her that this woman told him about an audio podcast to listen to, and that upon listening to it, it changed the way he looks at life. Devisha said Daniel told her the podcast showed him to view things in the world in a positive energy and to avoid negative energy. Devisha said he told her he was in love with this woman and ultimately made it sound as if they were in a relationship together. Police also asked his sister Devisha if she knew anything about any sort of medical or mental health issues that Daniel may have had. Devisha said she was not aware of Daniel having any medical or mental health issues. But she did inform police that Daniel had been acting odd in the days leading up to his disappearance. She said that Daniel came over once to her apartment and would just sit there for about 30 minutes and wouldn't say anything. She said she tried to talk to him, but he would just sit there and not respond. Devisha said he then walked out of the apartment. Daniel was last seen by his co-workers around 9:15 a.m. on June 23, 2021. Apparently, he met with a co-worker of his named Kenneth. He told police that Daniel was behaving strange. According to the police report, Kenneth works for another company that works along with Global Water. Kenneth said the day of the incident, June 23, 2021, was the first time he had met Daniel. Kenneth said they drove out to the job site, he in his vehicle and Daniel in his Jeep. Kenneth said they got to the job site at approximately 9:30 a.m. in the morning. Kenneth said when they got to the job site, at times he noticed that Daniel appeared to stare off into the distance or would just be staring at nothing in particular. Kenneth said Daniel would talk to him at times, but it was regarding topics that weren't related to the work that they were doing there. Kenneth said this was odd to him. According to Kenneth, he recalls Daniel asking him, "Do you want to go home? Do you want to go back to Phoenix?" Kenneth said at that time, it appeared it was going to rain. Kenneth said he told Daniel he would check the weather application on his cell phone. Kenneth stated as he began to look at the weather application on his cell phone, at about 9:45 a.m. in the morning, he saw Daniel wave to him as if he was waving goodbye. Kenneth said Daniel didn't say anything. He just walked over to his Jeep and drove away from the area. Kenneth said Daniel was last seen driving south on a dirt road from the job site. Kenneth explained that if Daniel continued south down the dirt road, he would come to a spot where the road splits to the west and to the east. He said after Daniel didn't come back to the area, he went looking for Daniel. Kenneth said at the split in the road, he saw some fresh tire tracks that went west. He said it had rained while they were out there, so he believed the rain washed away all the tire tracks, and the new tracks was from Daniel's vehicle. Kenneth said at that point, he went to a part of high ground to scan the area for Daniel, but ultimately couldn't find him. Kenneth said at some point after Daniel left the job site, he contacted his boss, Steve, informing him of what was going on. Kenneth stated he later received a message from Steve and other workers that Daniel did not contact anyone in the company since he had left the job site, and that no one knew where Daniel was. Kenneth ultimately reported no behavior or statements from Daniel that suggested he was hallucinating, that he was incoherent, and or was having some kind of a mental health issue. Kenneth added that Daniel did not make any direct or indirect suicidal statements or actions. So he started looking for him in the desert, following some tire tracks he thought could be Daniel, but was unable to find him. Co-workers contacted his father, who called the police. Authorities searched the area for hours with no success. Daniel's social media accounts had not been active since his disappearance, and all of the photos on his Instagrams have been deleted. On July 20th, 2021, Daniel's Jeep was discovered by a cattle rancher. It was found in a ravine 4 miles from where he was last seen. It appeared to have been in a pretty bad accident, and it was flipped upside down. The airbags were deployed. Daniel's keys, cell phone, wallet, and clothes, including his work boots and safety vest, were all found at the scene. But no Daniel. Initially, police reported that they didn't believe there was any foul play involved, but Daniel's family did not agree. "It doesn't sit right with me," his father, David Robinson, said. According to Daniel's family, investigators did not conduct any forensic testing on the Jeep. So Daniel's father hired his own private investigator to reconstruct the accident, and his findings was that the accident appeared to be staged. There was evidence that Daniel had been wearing his seatbelt at the time of the crash. He said, after the airbags came out, somebody turned that ignition over at least 46 times. There's an additional 11 miles on the car, so that tells me the car was driven around after the crash. On July 31st, 2021, police did find a human skull near the crash site, but were able to confirm that it did not belong to Daniel. According to Insider, David Robinson said, "The desert search for Daniel has led to the recovery of close to 5 or 6 human remains in the area we searched that belong to other missing persons. It has been over 2 months with no leads or evidence towards Daniel's disappearance, as well as failed tracking of his vehicle and phone GPS location that could determine exactly what happened that day. Daniel's family has offered a $10,000 reward for any information leading to Daniel's recovery. They also have a GoFundMe set up to help assist with the search costs in solving this case. I will leave a link to that in the description below." On Saturday, November 6, 2021, human remains were found. According to ABC's 15 News article, the Buckeye Police Department confirmed late Sunday in an email that officers responded to the area of Sun Valley Parkway and milepost 113 about possible human remains that were found as well as other evidence. Those remains have been sent out for official DNA testing and identification, according to the Buckeye Police. In a video update posted on Twitter on Sunday afternoon, Daniel's father, David, and his private investigator said that the remains do not appear to be that of Daniel's. However, they hope that once the remains are identified, it will bring closure to another grieving family. Anyone with information regarding Daniel Robinson's case is urged to come forward. You can do so by contacting the Buckeye Police Department at 623-349-6400. That's 623-349-6400. You can also submit an anonymous tip to Crime Stoppers at 888-274-6372. What do you guys think about this case? What are some of your theories? Please let me know in the comments down below. If you like videos like these, check out my last episode. I'll leave a link on the screen right here. Like, comment, subscribe, and share because it really helps me out. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!